手一按在墙壁上，整只手就拿不下来了。随后小哥分别在大腿、衣服上碰上墙壁胶。
Oceans cover about 70% of Earth's surface, but we know more about the geography of Mars than we do about what lies on the bottom of the sea. But all that might change. Around the world, people are looking to finally reveal the secrets of our deep oceans for both scientific and economic gains. So how close are we to completely mapping the ocean?
Gravity actually causes requires knowing what's down there so you don't mine it, for example. Right?
Wants this map, why hasn't it been done yet? Well, it'll cost a lot of money and take a lot of time, maybe as much as 200 ship years.
With the current day technology, it would take about 200 years for one ship to map the whole ocean, or 200 ships, 1 year. And the question is the cost. We've estimated that to map the entire ocean at a reasonable level of resolution would cost on the order of $3 billion. And you'd say, well, gee, who would ever spend $3 billion to map a planet? And I point to the fact that we've sent missions to the moon, which costs on the order of $600 million or so, and mapped the moon much better than we mapped our planet. We send missions to Mars, many missions to Mars. Each one of those missions costs between $2 and $3 billion.
One way to cut down on cost would be to do it faster, and the good news is that's the plan. What started as throwing a weight over the side of a boat has turned into utilizing acoustic waves. By sending hundreds of laser-like beams of sound into the ocean and measuring how long it takes to bounce them back, scientists can more accurately image the ocean's depths.
On the other hand, we're also trying to develop techniques to speed that up, to do it more quickly, and to do it maybe with autonomous vessels, with vessels that will be more efficient, that you don't have to have a crew on, and send autonomous vessels out for months at a time. And let them start collecting the data.
To put out drones that would go out and do it autonomously, that's a new forefront that's developing at the moment, but that's kind of still in its infancy, and the amount of drones that we need to go out to perform this, that's something that they're still building on.
So yes, one day in the near future, our oceans may be teeming with underwater drones or crewless ships crisscrossing the planet, collecting and sending data that will be transformed into a 3D map of our oceans, which is another hurdle we need to figure out. What do we do with all this data?
There's also a major challenge of trying to amass, collect, and synthesize this data. You know, it's one thing to have the data stored on, you know, 500,000 hard drives on 500,000 vessels, but you get it put all together in the same place.
And one group, the Nippon Foundation JEBCO Seabed 2030 Project, is looking to lead that fight. They're aiming to gather all the bathymetric data and produce the world's first highly detailed ocean map, and do it by 2030.
It's amazing how every time we go out a map in the unknown waters, we find something we didn't know about. And it's that kind of discovery and exploration that really drives at least me in terms of ocean mapping.
And it's that passion, along with their hard work, that has given those in the community the ability to work with and root for Seabed 2030 and their nearing deadline.
They could certainly use more resources if they're going to get close to hitting that goal, but I'm going to commit, at least aspirationally, I'm going to hope that they're right, that we'll have the oceans mapped by 2030.
The global initiative to have it done by 2030 is going to be quite an undertaking. It's going to depend on developing technology and a concerted effort from different players, but I'm optimistic and I think it will happen at some point.
We need a detailed map of the ocean to better understand the ocean. And to do this, we need people, ships, advanced technology, global cooperation, and of course, money. So how close are we to mapping the entire ocean? Well, all eyes are on Seabed 2030 and their goal to have a complete public map by, well, 2030.
And we're going to give it our darndest to do. It's a very, very ambitious goal. I'm not sure we will get 100% there, but we're certainly going to make some strides towards that. So that's our goal, is to see it all mapped by 2030.
现在啊，对于新上映的一系列电影，依旧会去电影院看看。
小时候就幻想着能够像影像中的超级英雄一样，有着上天入地的超能力，帮助人们拯救世界。国外有个小哥就用食用糖制作了一个机械手套，不知道坚不坚硬呢？首先，他买了一只手套作为模板，并在上面抹了一层厚厚的石灰。等它凝固以后，他将里面的手套取出，并在石灰制作的手套模型里倒入熬好的糖浆。等到里面的糖水凝固以后，初步的手套就已经制作完成了。小哥为了使它的颜色不那么单调，就在上面用一些可食用的颜料做了装饰，让它看起来更加像一个战斗手套。随后制作好以后，就肯定是要测试它的威力如何了。虽然不可能比得上电影中的机械手套，但是肯定比赤手空拳要好很多。第一个测试就是西瓜了。小哥戴上这个智能手套以后，朝着西瓜狠狠地砸去，西瓜在意料之中的被砸碎，手套也没有被砸坏。第二个测试就是坚硬的椰子。固定住，然后找到它最脆弱的地方。小哥拿起超薄手套往前一砸，坚硬的椰子也是没被砸碎，果汁到处乱溅。可以看出，超薄手套的威力也是不小的呢。还有网友发言说道：“这么大的糖就这么浪费了，也是可惜了。”好了，今天的故事就到这里了。喜欢的小伙伴记得评论。